In the last video, I showed you how to hide, unhide, move, and reorder items in the learning path. Because I started personalizing my course by hiding and reordering some items, in this video I want to show you how you can rename units and items, and then I also want to show you how you can create some new units and folders in your learning path. So if you remember in the last video, I moved Chapter 3 on Memory down closer to Chapter 7 on Thinking, because that's the way I like to cover it in my class. Because I did that reorder, that change, and because I teach this course usually in an 8-week session, I like to name my units after weeks instead of chapters. Well, it's very, very easy to rename these folders or these units. If you remember when I clicked on the Edit button in the last video, that was to show you how to move items and how to reorder them. I'm going to show you by clicking on that Edit button, you can also rename your folders. So scroll to the top where the unit title is, and I want to change it from Chapter 1 on Discovering Yourself to just Week 1. I could do Week 1, : Discovering Yourself if I want to still keep part of the chapter name in there, or I could just name it Week 1. I could do the same thing to Chapter 2 and notice how immediately it changes it. So right when I close it in the learning path, it's updated immediately. And I click Save. And then I want to do that with the rest of the units. So Chapter 4 will now be Week 3, because remember I moved Chapter 3 down. So Chapter 4, Chapter 5 will follow those. Now I want to show you how to create a new unit and a new folder. So one of the things I like to do in my class is create a unit on college resources. And that's very easy to do and to add to the learning path. So when you're on the main page, on the main learning path, you'll see a little plus button over here on the right-hand side. It's the Add Content button. When you click on it, it gives you three options: to add a folder, add a unit, or add an activity. For right now, we're going to add a unit. A unit is another way, in my opinion, of saying a module. So if I click this module, or this unit, I can add a unit titled College Resources, and then click Save. Notice that when I do that, it automatically puts the resources or the new unit that I just created, which happens to be College Resources, at the bottom. I could have initially changed it. Sometimes it's easy to forget. Just know that you can always go back in and place it where you want it to be. I want it to be before the introduction. So I'm going to, from the drop-down menu, pick to place the College Resources unit right in front of the introduction, the master student, and then I click Save. Once I do that, you see automatically that College Resources unit is created and moved up to the very top. Now let's say I want to add a folder within this College Resources unit. Notice how it's blank right now. There's no items in it. So let's say I want to add a folder on academic support. So I can choose a folder on academic support, and in this folder I can add links to advising and counseling and tutoring. So the first thing I want to do is create the folder. Then what I want to do is I want to add those links into advising and counseling. So I want to add content again. This time I'm going to add an activity, and we're going to talk a little bit more about this later, so I'm going to do this quickly. It's more to show you what the folder will look like when it's done. So I'm going to add this activity. Once I add the activity and save it, it's going to give me the option of where to put that activity, and I want to put it in the academic support folder. So I'm going to choose academic support folder right from the add to location drop down menu, and then when I click save, you will see that now the advising and counseling link is under academic support. So when I click on it, it takes them right to that page. So I can add more items. Like I said, I could add a link to the tutoring center here and such. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can really customize your course by adding existing activities like videos, web links, and RSS feeds. And then I'm going to show you how you can go even a step further by adding your own personal activities and assignments.